The summer prior in 2019 or spring prior is when Carlette and I met, and I did the life coaching certification program. And I came to that program because I needed a change in myself. I needed a different way of doing things. I was schooled in old school coaching and it wasn't working in the style that I needed to have, like coming from a position of love and understanding that toughness can be a part of that equation. And so I came to Carlette like I was hitting my head against a wall and I needed change and I needed to kind of step into my own leadership instead of trying to do it the way others had showed me or taught me, or feeling like I had to fill a certain mold that pre-existed in the program. But I ended up leaving the program in the summer of 2020 after the pandemic. And after two kids and knowing that I wanted another one, it was just so demanding overseeing. By the time I left, we had 75 student athletes on the men's and women's team. I had a full staff and it just was a real challenge. And I knew that I wanted to have more children and something had to give. So 2020 was that moment where I realized when everything calmed down for the first time that I was really home with my children and that I valued that was really important to me. And this is what drew me to Carlette, was like, I was trying to be something that I wasn't. Like, I didn't know how to step into my own like value system and my own style and have confidence in that.
So did you mostly coach the way that you were coached?
Yeah, absolutely.
By the guys.
Yeah. And that was one of the reasons
post-college.
That was one of the reasons why that guy that was on the team at Georgetown, when I spoke to him a couple of weeks ago, like that was one of the reasons why he was like, you would have been a great men's coach, because I was coaching in a way that was resonating more with them. Like I was very, I wasn't like mean, but I was cut and dry. Like I knew what it took to be great. And I wanted the athletes to like join me in that journey.